Hi, my name is Christopher Westfall. I'm an insurance agent that specializes in the senior demographic, specifically Medicare and Medicare insurance. Today, I want to give you an update specific to our demographic. Those are people 65 or turning 65, and how this coronavirus pandemic, and specifically the unemployment rate, is affecting them. This might benefit someone you know. If it does, please share this information with them. A lot of things have happened. You've seen it in the news. It's increasingly worse as I record this, but we're going to turn the corner. You're not alone. People are getting through this, and we can help you as it pertains to your benefit. So I just want to go through a little bit of background as to the senior demographic when it comes to employment in general. And losing your employment is never something that's easy, obviously. And the more people I talk to during this crisis are telling me that they have to make decisions now that they did not think before that they had to make until 12, 24, or even 36 or 72 months later. They wanted to continue working past 65. Sometimes those options are no longer their own. So what do you do when a time like that happens? Well, according to the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics, we've been looking at a bunch of trends in the senior demographic. More seniors are working now than ever before. In the age range from 65 to 74, it has been growing to almost 40% of the people are working. Look at this chart. The annual growth rate in labor, and this is anticipated from 2014 all the way to 2024, look at the growth in 64 years old to 74 years old. People are working longer and longer. Primarily, they say economists predict that this is happening only because of the good health that people are enjoying, which is great. And it should always be your choice, of course. And if you look at the occupations that they're saying that seniors are holding on to longer, it's mostly management, professional. And what this tends to point at is if an employer, a large employer that makes millions of dollars in a Fortune 500 company, if their senior leadership is predominantly someone over the age of 55, and they need to cut corners, who do they tend to go for first when they have to do the layoffs? Unfortunately, it is the senior demographic impacted more than any other. And then a lot of the people we work with are self-employed. They've had their own business. They've been running their own business. And again, because of this coronavirus pandemic, they've had to make other lifestyle choices. Some of them are to come off of their employment insurance that they've set up for their own company and now consider going to Medicare maybe for the first time. So a large portion of the people who are self-employed in the country as a whole are the seniors. And typically they don't want to just, you know, bug out, sell out at 65. They want to continue with their expertise in growing the business. The percentage of wage and salary workers 65 and older by tenure. This is how long is a senior typically staying in the workforce. The reason why they've called it, you know, the greatest generation for so long is because the seniors are the ones that continue to show up. They're consistent at work. They're not just jumping from job to job to job. And the purple line here indicates the percentage of which the seniors have been at their one job for 10 years or longer. And the statistic from the Bureau of Labor Statistics says 1.1 million wage and salary workers age 65 and older have been with their current employer for two or fewer years, but those workers accounted for 15% of all the other people that are 65 plus. So if you look at the other way, 85% of the people are longer than 2 years with an employer. And then we look at part-time workers. This impacts my family, my mother-in-law. She is a part-time worker because she wanted to continue to get the insurance benefits from work. That's the primary motivator. That's why she has stayed there for so long, and that number has continued to go up. We know that there's a huge disparity between age 55 and 65, as with the Affordable Care Act and all the other forms of insurance that are available, that's the most expensive demographic to pay for your own insurance. So of course the incentive has been to get that employment insurance to cover that. And we know the unemployment claims, these are the figures that just came out today as I record this. It's off the chart, 22 million people now affected.
So people understand, if you add that to the job losses from the three previous weeks, that makes 22 million, which is roughly all the jobs that were added to the U.S. economy since the Great Recession, correct?
Correct. we're approaching that level. And remember, this is just in the space of 4 weeks. 5 weeks ago, these people were getting on with their lives. They had jobs. And in the space of 4 weeks, wiped out a whole decade near of job gains. That's what's so unimaginable about this for these people and for these families.
So where does that leave us now? What are the options? I want to give you a list of resources that you can spend some time when you have it investigating what your options are if you're considering coming over to Medicare. If you're approaching age 65, then this can happen on the first of the month that you're turning 65. Depending on how long in the future that is, you might want to get moving on this. Due to the coronavirus pandemic, and this will change later as they're opening the Social Security offices, but right now you cannot go down to your local Social Security office, make an appointment, get a number, and come back in and sit down and meet with the benefits person there at Social Security. You can't do it. So their phone lines in Washington are overwhelmed. Their online application process is running slow, sometimes glitching over and over again. We're hearing this. We have obtained from Social Security the best guidance in getting your Part B, that's your part of Medicare that you have to pay for to be on Medicare. There's Part A that's a hospital part, that's automatic. It's the Part B that covers almost everything, and that's all the outpatient services. And so getting Part B started after the age of 65 is a manual process. You have to go through a series of steps. I want to make that as easy for you as possible. That's what we help people with every day. Seems more and more every day we're helping with this because more people are not just turning 65 starting with Medicare. They're starting Medicare due to this new unemployment, reducing the hours, furloughed, etc. So if you want to make a list, get something to write with, maybe you can pause this video right now. I've made some resources available that I think will help you in your education journey through considering if Medicare is a good fit for you. Now you have to take into consideration a couple of things. That is, first, paying to be on Part B. That's typically not that much money unless you've had a big income earnings period for the last 2 years. Then you'd have to pay an adjustment to that, but I'll explain that in future videos. And they can tell you exactly how that pertains to you when you contact Social Security or look at your record on ssa.gov. But when you're getting started with Medicare after the age of 65, there are two forms necessary to get that ball rolling for you. Typically, our advice would be to take those forms down to your local Social Security office and hand them to a benefits person there who can get that started for you in a timely fashion. However, they've locked the doors. No one's allowed inside. So how do you accomplish that? That's why I made a special website called howtostartmedicare.com. If you're approaching 65, this site will help you. If you're after 65 and just now starting Medicare, this site will help you as well. So check out howtostartmedicare.com if you want to write that down. Here are some other resources as you're considering what to supplement Medicare with, because Medicare itself is good coverage. There's original Medicare, that is. You can go to any hospital that accepts Medicare nationwide. You can go to any provider that you want to across the country because most all of them accept Medicare. There's no referrals required, no pre-authorization required to get things done and fixed. And you don't have a medical director per se telling you, oh, we have to run this through and see if we can get this done cheaper somewhere else. That's original Medicare. It's great insurance. The problem is that it only pays for, I'm talking about Part B, the outpatient part, only pays for 80% of Medicare approved charges. So that leaves you with an unlimited 20% of all of your Medicare bills that you have to end up paying. And more things are done on an outpatient basis. So really it's the Part B component of Medicare, that's the outpatient part, where we really want to have protection from having some kind of insurance. And I'll go through those options with you here shortly. So howtostartmedicare.com is the first thing to getting onto Medicare. You have the forms there. Then we have another one to consider, Medicare Advantage or Medicare Supplement. There's a big difference there, and I've got a lot of videos that you can look at to see the difference. The easiest one is this. If you type in allaboutmedicareadvantage.com, you can see a playlist that I've created over the years where we've documented the differences in the chronological history of what's been going on with Medicare Advantage plans. Now, there are two different paths to go on. One is the road less traveled. That is Medicare Supplement. I mentioned before, original Medicare is good insurance. You can go anywhere you want to. That's true. but it only pays for 80% of the Medicare-approved charges for outpatient things. Going into the hospital, it's only around $1,300 when you check yourself into the hospital, and then Part A kicks in. The supplements also pay for that. So a Medicare supplement, otherwise called a Medigap plan, sits on top of your original Medicare, which is good, making good Medicare even better, filling up the holes and allowing you to get the health care that you need to get without worrying about that 20%, you know, unlimited number. So that's Medicare supplement. And the other side, the other path, which is getting more and more popular because there's so much money from the government pushing the advertising of these plans, it's called Medicare Advantage. Some of my clients have called it Medicare Disadvantage. It's where you give up your original Medicare rights, and that is the ability to go to any doctor, any hospital in the country that accepts Medicare with no referrals, no pre-authorizations, and no medical director telling you what you can have done. You give that up, in essence, for the year contract that you're on a Medicare Advantage plan. When you're new to Medicare, you have a critical decision to make, because after this initial election period, that's the time that you're brand new to Medicare, after that period expires, you will forevermore be possibly limited in what you can choose to supplement your Medicare. If you want a Medicare supplement plan with the freedoms and flexibility that I described before, you can travel anywhere in the country with no network restrictions whatsoever. That Medicare supplement can only be obtained when you are in your initial election period. And for Medicare supplements, that runs 6 months from the time that your Part B starts. For 6 months past your Part B start date, you can start a Medicare supplement anywhere in the country with no health underwriting, no questions asked, no pre-existing conditions, no worries whatsoever. After that 6 months is over, depending on your state, and there are very few that have no restrictions on this, you would have to health qualify, that is, answer certain health questions to get onto a Medicare supplement plan. There's a barrier to get there after the open enrollment period for you because it's better insurance. What I found in my life is anything that you have to go out and actually qualify for is typically better. It's the best coverage that you can have. So that's the Medicare supplement. The alternative is giving up the freedom and flexibility of original Medicare in lieu of a HMO or PPO plan that typically costs no premium. Now, you still have to pay to be on Medicare, your Part B premium we talked about earlier, and that's on howtostartmedicare.com. But in addition to your A and B, you could choose to do Medicare Advantage. Now, that means that all the red, white, and blue benefits of original Medicare, the freedom, flexibility, no network, no referrals, choose any doctor, don't have to have a referral or a primary care doctor, all those limitations are now in full effect. With an HMO on Medicare Advantage, you have a network, you have restrictions, you have referrals necessary to go see a specialist if they approve it, and it must be in the network. Any care, unless it's an emergency, any care that you have obtained outside of the network and outside of the rules of a Medicare Advantage plan, when you're on one, are covered at exactly 0%. If you're on a PPO plan, then that provider must accept the terms and the payments from that plan and agree to see you with those terms. And generally on a Medicare Advantage PPO plan, you have an in-network option and you have an out-of-network option, typically at much higher cost to you. But still, the out-of-network option must be acceptable to that provider. Sometimes they don't want to bill insurance companies and wait and get a reduced payment back. So if you're going to be on a Medicare Advantage plan, I highly recommend being on a PPO plan if it's available, just so at least you have the option and you're not ending up paying 100% of the bill with no limitation whatsoever, which is what happens if you've given up your original Medicare for an Advantage plan on an HMO and you decide to go outside the network or outside of what the treatment plan has been approved for you or outside the specialist that is approved for you or outside the primary care doctor that they've chosen for you or that you've chosen that was in the plan. So you've got Medicare Advantage with restrictions and limitations on it, and they typically will go for the cheapest amount of coverage necessary for any illness or surgery. They have to eliminate the cheapest first before they'll pay for the full thing. Or you have Medicare supplements. So that decision to make is most critically important when you're new to Medicare, because you could be stuck on the Medicare Advantage without the option of upgrading, going to a supplement in the future if your health in the future does not allow you to do that. Now, if you remain healthy for as long as you live, then every option in the world is always available to you. You can always get onto a Medicare supplement plan when the contract year of your Advantage plan runs out at the end of the calendar year. You could opt for the next year to come onto a supplement plan. Typically in my office, we hear it thousands of times every year. We have someone who joined a Medicare Advantage plan. It was going great. Zero premium. Love it, love it, love it. It's a great thing. I've got a small copay. I love my doctor. Everything's great. Then bam, something major happens. The warranty expires on a body part. And then you start finding out that, as we've covered in prior videos, and the Kaiser Family Foundation did a study and found out that a significant number of Medicare Advantage plans across the country will actually be charging you more for a hospital stay than if you had no insurance, no supplement, no Advantage, nothing at all, if you were just back on to original Medicare with nothing else. Being on original Medicare is sometimes cheaper than having a Medicare Advantage plan when you're fully admitted into the hospital. And then you have to be on a network hospital, otherwise it's not covered at all, unless it's an emergency, and just then until you're stabilized. So you've got Medicare Advantage, Medicare supplement, big choices to make there, and that's what we specialize in, is walking through all of those options that fit not only your lifestyle and your health situation, but also your budget. Because let's face it, sometimes people just don't have another option. They've got to get a zero premium plan. So how do you plug those holes so that your exposure is not the maximum that they could be on a zero premium, virtually free Medicare Advantage plan? There are some strategies to do that. But this is about education, and I just want to point out some resources that are available to you. So educate yourself before you sign up for a Medicare Advantage plan, just to know what the common pitfalls are, what we've seen, what HHS has come out and said, what the Office of Inspector General has come out and said about Medicare Advantage. You owe it to yourself to have this kind of education. And then we have another one resource for you, MedicareAdvantageNearMe.com. Let's say you decide that Medicare Advantage is good for you. You can live with the restrictions. You're going to be in perfect health for the rest of your life. You know that. You know, your mother and father live to be 106 years old. You're going to be fine. Just give me that zero premium plan. This is a resource of plans that we have handpicked across the country, where we have selected these plans to work with based on a variety of criteria that we have vetted in my office. These are plans that we work with, and you can look at those plans at your leisure. You can see what doctors are in there, how much they cover on the drugs if it's included, all of that at MedicareAdvantageNearMe.com. Now let's talk about Medicare supplements and get the balancing picture. My website is at seniorsavingsnetwork.org. Right there on the front page is everything you need to know about these choices that I've just talked about. I think it's called the five steps to getting on Medicare plans and looking at the details behind them. There's a lot of educational resources there, and you can reach out to my team there. That's seniorsavingsnetwork.org. Another resource is planinmedicare.org. Plan N is one of the most popular now Medicare supplement plans that's available for you. And this research shows 18 different data points over many, many months of research, showing all the different Medicare supplement plans, Plan F, Plan G, Plan N, the three top plans that are out there sold from all the companies, and showing what the trend is, what's happening with Medicare supplemental insurance right now, Medigap plans. This is priceless information. Robert and my office compiled this data from a lot of different companies over a long period of time, and we've seen the trends. I called it first in 2015. It's absolutely come true. If you're considering a Medicare supplement plan, first, please consider letting me help you with it. And secondly, look at this research, because no one else has it. Well, they might start copying it by now, but planinmedicare.org. You'll see all the plans compared side by side and what the trend line is happening. The point is, I want a senior that starts on Medicare to be able to afford their Medicare insurance until they're no longer on this earth. If you choose a wrong plan and your health prevents you from changing, you're stuck on that plan until you can no longer afford it anymore. Medicare supplements, all of them, go up in rates. Year after year after year, they go up in rates. So it's the trend, it's the research behind the recommendation that is so critically important. These are the data points we watch across the country with all the carriers so that we can intelligently make a recommendation and then help you secure that coverage. Oh, and our service does not cost a dime. It's just already included with insurance, just like your car insurance agent, just like your homeowner's insurance agent. It's already built in. So let us as independent brokers find the best plan for you, but please look at this data. It's free, planinmedicare.org. And then if you do choose a Medicare supplement route, that's original Medicare with all of its freedoms, a Medicare supplement to take care of the holes that Medicare itself does not pay for, you've looked at Plan In and you've looked at the other plans, you will need a Part D drug plan to go with it, at least to consider to have it so that if you need it later in life, you don't have a lifetime penalty for not having obtained one. At startpartd.com, I've got a video explaining the characteristics of drug plans, what to look for, and then a tool where you can do a self-enrollment and look at the plans that we've chosen to work with and why. And then you could do an enrollment there, and it takes about 5 minutes. It's very easy. There's no credit card or banking information needed. It can just tie into your Social Security check to withdraw the premiums for that and take care of your plan selection. You have to be within your enrollment period in order to get a Part D drug plan. So if you're losing other coverage, if you're losing employment coverage, then when you're checking out at that plan, you will need to pick a special election period code of losing employer or union coverage. It's very important that you pick that, because if you're older than 65 and you're no longer in your initial election period for Medicare, then you have to have a special permission to get a drug plan. You can't just get one anytime you want to. Every year, you have an annual enrollment period from October 15th through December 7th where you can pick the drug plan for next year, and my website works for that as well. Anything that you pick during the annual enrollment period, October 15th through December 7th, goes into effect on January 1 of the next year. But the purpose of this video is we're specifically talking about the potential people who are losing their employment insurance and brand new to Medicare. That creates a special election period, otherwise known as an SEP, and you have to put that on the application. You'll pull down a little list of the reasons why, and you have to select losing employer or union coverage. And you have to do this within 60 days of losing that coverage to get a Part D drug plan. If you have any questions about that, you can reach out to my team. But this information, all these sites, available 24 hours a day, and we'll answer those questions for you. I hope this has been of some value to you. There are resources out there that I want to make available so that you can do your own research and educate yourself on what's available, but my team is here to guide you through it. We may be working virtually through the crisis during the storm. We've been out now for 6 weeks as I record this. I'm the only one in the office today, but we're here for you. We're answering the phones and we're calling people back that call late at night. We're answering emails and we're helping seniors to pick the best plans for their situation, and everyone's different. Please let us help you. My name is Christopher Westfall. God bless you where you are. You're not alone. We're going to get through the crisis. We are. And if I can help you to make the insurance choice easier, that's what I'm here for. Thank you so much for watching. And please share this with someone who you might think would benefit from it. And if you wouldn't mind, hit the subscribe button below. Maybe turn on that bell notification on YouTube so that you can be notified when things change with Medicare, because they do. They constantly change with Medicare. And that's what I spend all of my days and all of my nights researching and staying on top of, so that we can be the best resource for seniors that are out there. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.